गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. दिस इज 12th क्लास बायोलॉजी, लेक्चर 12 ऑफ चैप्टर 6. एंड टुडे यू विल लर्न अबाउट डीएनए फिंगरप्रिंटिंग. डीएनए फिंगरप्रिंटिंग इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड डीएनए प्रोफाइलिंग. सो डीएनए फिंगरप्रिंटिंग इज अ टेक्निक विच इज यूज टू आइडेंटिफाई द सिमिलैरिटीज ऑफ डीएनए ऑफ टू इंडिविजुअल्स. सो हेयर two individuals DNA is matched for the similarities, or you can say for the dissimilarities. And this technique of DNA fingerprinting was developed by Alec Jeffries in 1985. DNA of an organism carries some non-coding sequences. You know about the non-coding sequences of DNA, and these sequences are called repetitive sequences. Okay. And satellite DNA is also a part of that repetitive sequence. And in that, there is one category, mini satellite. I have already told you about the mini satellite and micro satellite, right? Now, this mini satellite DNAs are also called variable number tandem repeats. Tandem repeats means highly repeated sequences. Okay. So in mini satellite DNA, there are highly repetitive DNA sequences are present, okay, and these repetitive sequences are present in variable number, means a difference of number is present in DNAs of different people. That's why these are called variable number tandem repeats. And these variable number of tandem repeats are the basis of DNA fingerprinting. As I told you in the previous lecture, that repetitive sequences are the base for the DNA profiling. So here, which repetitive sequence? That is mini satellite, or you can say variable number of tandem repeats, VNTR, is the basis for DNA fingerprinting. Number of repeats is specific from person to person, means it can vary. Now, first step of DNA fingerprinting is isolation of DNA. First of all, DNA will be isolated from any cell or blood stain. For example, if the DNA fingerprinting is for any crime case, in that case, from the criminal's spot, blood stain can be taken to isolate the DNA, or semen stains or hair roots. So anything, means any cell can be taken for the isolation of DNA. Second step is amplification of DNA. Amplification means making many copies of DNA. And how it is done? By polymerase chain reaction. That is called PCR. And about the PCR, you will study in the unit biotechnology. Okay, so with the help of this polymerase chain reaction, DNA is amplified. Many copies of that DNA is made. Because if we have very small sample of that DNA, it will become very difficult to do many tests with that. Okay. So that DNA amplification is very important step. After that, third step is digestion of DNA by restriction endonucleases. So here, restriction endonucleases are the enzymes which can cut DNA at specific sites. Okay. So here the fragments of DNA are made, and making these fragments of DNA is called digestion of DNA. And how these fragments are made? By restriction endonuclease enzyme, because these enzymes will cut the DNA at specific sites and will make the fragments. So here you can see, this is DNA sample which has been isolated. After that, this restriction enzyme is used here to make these fragments of DNA. Okay. Now, step 4. After the after using the restriction endonuclease, we have the fragments of DNA. Now, these fragments of DNA will be separated. So, separation of DNA fragments by gel electrophoresis. So here, this is a gel electrophoretic machine, you can see. Okay, this is a plate-like structure. And here, you can see these structure. These are well-like structure. Here, the DNA will be loaded. Okay, and the fragments of DNA will be separated according to the size. the greater means the larger and smaller fragments of DNA will get separated as the bands will appear here in this electrophoretic machine, right? About this electrophoresis technique also, you will study in biotechnology unit in detail. After this, fifth step will be treat with alkali solution, that is NaOH, sodium hydroxide, to denature DNA bonds into gel, into single strands. So here what is done? NaOH is added. And this NaOH, what will it do? It will denature the DNA. Denaturation of DNA means separation of two strands of DNA. As you know, DNA is double-stranded structure. So by using NaOH, these two strands will get separated. So these single strands you can see here. You can see this denaturation of DNA has occurred here. After the denaturation, what will be the next step? Transferring or blotting of separated single-stranded DNA fragments to synthetic membranes. And what is that synthetic membrane that is used here? That is made up of nitrocellulose or nylon. So nitrocellulose or nylon membrane is used here to take that separated strand of DNA and then baked in a vacuum oven at 80 degrees Celsius for 3 to 5 hours to fix the DNA fragments on the membrane. So what is done here? That nitrocellulose membrane or nylon membrane is kept over the gel. Okay, gel means where the DNA fragments have been separated, and these DNA fragments are single stranded. So now when we will keep the nylon membrane over that, those DNA fragments will come on the nylon membrane. Then we will keep it into oven at 80 degrees Celsius so that the DNA can fix to the membrane. After this nitrocellulose membrane is kept in a solution containing radioactive labeled single-stranded DNA probe. So what is this DNA probe here? This is a single-stranded DNA which is made radioactive. And what is its function here? To check the complementarity with another single-stranded DNA which is present on the nitrocellulose membrane. Okay, because from the gel we have taken single-stranded DNA on the nitrocellulose membrane. Now we need to check the complementarity of those single-stranded DNA with the DNA probe. So this DNA probe is made radioactive here. Why it is made radioactive? Because radioactive DNA can be seen easily by the autoradiography later on. Okay, so here this DNA probe is made radioactive, and then nitrocellulose membrane is kept in that solution in which this DNA probe is present. The DNA probe binds with the complementary sequences of the DNA fragment on the membrane to form a hybridized DNA. Okay, if there will be any complementary strand on the nitrocellulose membrane, then the DNA probe will bind with that and will form a hybridized DNA. And this hybridized DNA will be visible by the autoradiography. So here the filter paper, after this step, there will be 8th step. And what is that? The filter paper is washed to remove unbound probe. Okay, nitrocellulose membrane will be washed so that the unbound probe will be removed from that. After that, in 9th step, what will be done? The hybridized DNA is photographed on an X-ray film. So like this. This is a X-ray film, and by autoradiography, hybridized DNA can be visualized here. The image in the form of dark and light bands. So here you can see these dark bands and these light bands. So the image will appear in the form of dark and light bands of the hybridized DNA. And these images, means like light and dark bands, it will be called DNA fingerprinting. So where the DNA will be hybridized, these bands will appear, otherwise not. So this will be called DNA fingerprinting. How the hybridization will occur? Only when there will be complementarity between the DNA probe and the single strands of DNA which are present on the nitrocellulose membrane. So if there is any complementarity, it means those DNA are from the same source, or you can say from the same person, and this will be a basis for the DNA fingerprinting, because only in that case hybridized DNA bands will appear on the X-ray film by autoradiography. So this is complete DNA fingerprinting process. Now see here, by this image you can better understand that how this DNA fingerprinting is done. So here first of all see these are two suspected person. Consider there is a crime case and these two individuals are suspected in that case, individual A and individual B. So DNA will be taken from both, okay, and we are taking some samples here, like three chromosomes are studied here from the DNA of these two person, chromosome number 7, 2 and chromosome number 16. Either all the chromosomes are studied, but here we are taking for the you can say for the sample, this chromosome number 7, 2 and 16. And here you can see here in the chromosome number 7 of individual A, what is the number of tandem repeats? These boxes are showing the number of tandem repeats, because DNA fingerprinting is based on the variable number of tandem repeats. So these are tandem repeats. How many? 1, 2, 3. 3 are present here in the paternal chromosome, and in the maternal chromosome, these will be 4. Right? These are homologous chromosome, because an individual get one chromosome from the father, that will be called paternal chromosome, and one chromosome from the mother, that will be called maternal chromosome, right? So these are two chromosomes present here in one individual. These are two homologous chromosome, which are chromosome number 7. Okay, likewise these two homologous chromosomes are chromosome number 2, one from father and one from mother, and here also you can see the number of tandem repeats. Okay, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. Then this is chromosome number 16, paternal and maternal like this. For same for the individual B also, chromosome number 7, 2 and 16. So you can see here number of tandem repeats are different on different chromosomes, right? And for the different individuals also, here you can see for the chromosome number 7, here for the paternal chromosome only 3 tandem repeats are present, but here in this case how many, so many tandem repeats are present for the individual B, right? So the number of these tandem repeats are different in different persons. Okay, now what is done first, this is gel electrophoretic plate, okay, in which gel is present, and these are two wells in which DNA is loaded, means DNA from individual A and individual B is taken here and loaded in these wells like this. Then when the electrophoresis process will occur, will start, these bands of DNA will be formed on the basis of size. These fragments of DNA will get separate. Okay, first you must learn the steps of DNA fingerprinting. Okay, so one of the step was there, na, that gel electrophoresis on which the fragments of DNA get separated. So this is that step. Okay, so these fragments of DNA get separated on the basis of their size here. So from individual A, see here how these bands are separated. Now you can see here chromosome number 7, 3 tandem repeats are present here. So here we are writing the numbers for the tandem repeats. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 12 we are writing here. And here you see this color is showing the tandem repeats of the chromosome number 7. So here you can see 3. So these tandem repeats, this band is formed here at number 3. Then in maternal chromosome of the same chromosome number 7, how many tandem repeats are present? 4. And that's why this second band is present at tandem repeat number 4, right? Then come to the next chromosome, that is this orange one, okay, and this is chromosome number 2. This orange, for this orange colored here, yellow color is shown. Okay, so this same process we will do with it. Just count the tandem repeats, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8, right? And here number 8, So one band is present here at the number 8, and in another chromosome it is at number 7, means number of tandem repeats are 7, that's why second band is at number 7. For this blue color, means the chromosome number 16, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so one band will be at 5 and another band will be at 10, because these numbers are 10. Likewise, these bands will be formed for the individual B also. You can check all these, okay? You must check all these. Like for the blue color, there one band will be at the second position because two tandem repeats are here. So second position, okay, two tandem repeats. Then for the same chromosome number 16, homologous chromosome, there are 5 tandem repeats. So the second band will be at this 5th position, okay? And likewise for all others. Then after this, what is done here? This DNA has been taken from the crime scene, okay? And we are studying the same chromosomes here also, because the suspected person, for the suspected person, individual A and individual B also, we are studying chromosome number 7, 2 and 16. So here also we are taking chromosome number 7, 2 and 16 for the matching, okay? And here also, these when the DNA of this DNA which has been taken from the crime scene will be loaded here in the well of the electrophoretic plate, then these bands will be obtained. Okay, and you can see the position of these band according to the tandem repeats present in the chromosome. As here in the blue color, means in the chromosome number 16, these two bands are present. That's why this band is shown at the second position. And this is this has been done in the same way as we have done for these. Okay, so these bands will appear like this. Now you need to match the positions of bands here, because the hybridization will occur on the basis of the size of the DNA fragment here, okay? So just match the bands. These bands are means this crime scene bands are not matched with the DNA bands of the individual A, but these are matching with the DNA bands of individual B, right? You can see here all the bands are matching here. It means this DNA from the crime scene and this DNA of the individual B is same for the three chromosomes. Okay, all the tandem repeats are same. Number of tandem repeats are same here. It means who is criminal? This individual B is criminal. Okay, so this is how the DNA fingerprinting is done. Now, what are applications of DNA fingerprinting? First is forensic tool to solve the problems of paternity. Paternity means if there is any doubt that who is the father of the child, in that case, so paternity test is done with the DNA fingerprinting. That in case of rape or murder, etc., in these cases, DNA fingerprinting is done. Also for the diagnosis of genetic diseases. And third, to determine the phylogenetic status of the animal, means the evolutionary relationship of the animals, this DNA fingerprinting can be used. I hope this topic is clear to you. I know this is a little bit tricky topic. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Your today's homework is, do the NCERT question number 13. What is DNA fingerprinting? Mention its application. Okay, that is based on today's topics. And as it is the last topic of the chapter, so also do the assignment that has been uploaded on the adquark.com. Now let's discuss the answer of question number 14 of NCERT that I gave in homework in previous lecture. And B and D part I gave in homework. So B part is about the polymorphism, that describe the polymorphism. So what is polymorphism? It is form of genetic variation, means variation at DNA level in which distinct nucleotide sequences can exist at a particular site in DNA molecule. It arises due to mutation either in somatic cell or in germ cells. Now germ cell mutations can transmitted from parents to offspring because germ cells are involved with the gamete formation. Now these means polymorphism results in accumulation of various mutations in a population, leading to variation and polymorphism in the population. This plays a very important role in the process of evolution and speciation means formation of species. After that, D part of the question number 14 is bioinformatics. So what is bioinformatics? I told you earlier that when the computational techniques are used for the biological processes, that becomes bioinformatics. So bioinformatics is the application of computational and statistical techniques to the field of molecular biology. Okay, means for storing the data about the DNA and RNA at the molecular basis. So it helps in the management and analysis of biological data. Enormous amount of data generated during the process of human genome project. As you know, during the human genome project, so much data was generated that has to be managed and stored for easy access and interpretation for future use by various scientists. So for that, bioinformatics was used, means computer techniques were used to store that data.